everybody a second here to find their seats. Thanks for hanging with us. We're going to get things going here momentarily. Good evening, everybody. Thanks for coming back. Hope you had a great day here at Hilton Coliseum. On behalf of the State Science and Technology Fair of Iowa Board of Directors, we would like to welcome you all back to our awards ceremony, our special awards ceremony here for tonight. Tonight is a celebration of a year's worth of science research, learning, and discovery for over 600 students exhibiting over 475 projects from more than 70 junior and senior high schools that span the entire state of Iowa. We will tonight be honoring your science research by awarding various special awards from certificates, medallions, prizes, and scholarships from Iowa colleges, universities, and nonprofit organizations. By the way, my name is Zane Satry. I'm a former Iowa 4-H'er. I'm originally from Boone County, not too far west of here. I currently work as a meteorologist at KCCI-TV in Des Moines. So I will be serving as your MC for the evening. So welcome everybody officially to tonight's special award ceremony. We're gonna recognize outstanding pre-collegiate research and reward this research with, here's the details, more than $100,000 in awards and scholarships. I'd like to take this opportunity to thank all of you who helped make our fair today a success. Volunteers, judges, parents, teachers, sponsors, you're all critical to this fair's existence and success. So let's give a round of applause to all those who have made the fair possible. Tonight, I have the distinct honor to introduce Dr. Jason Henderson, Vice President of Iowa State University Extension and Outreach, to officially welcome him to, Iowa State University. Please help me in welcoming Dr. Henderson, who is attending his very first State Science and Technology Fair of Iowa, by giving him a warm welcome to the stage.
Well, good evening, everyone. Oh, I thought you were all excited for the award ceremony. Good evening, everyone. Oh, great. I'm so excited for all having you all here today, and welcome to Iowa State University. I know many of you had taken tours of our campus, and we just appreciate the opportunity to host you here today. Iowa State is about innovation. It's about discovery and research and what many of you did today, right? Talking about your experiments, whether it was how to filter water, right? To figuring out how to play music with different types of instruments that we were designing yourselves. And with that, I just want to say thank you for all the work that you did, because it was part of the innovations that make our world better each and every day. And it's the spark of science and science fairs that make that happen. But in order to make that really happen, it also takes people to mentor you, to teach you along the way. So to all of the judges and the volunteers and the staff that helped put on this great event together, would you all please stand up so we can honor you and thank you for your time and mentoring? It's also time, I saw many different pieces of equipment, some of them very expensive and some of it very inexpensive. But oftentimes that takes the help of parents. So if you're a parent, would you please stand up so we can thank you for all of your time? Yeah. So one of the things as I leave tonight, because the most important things are the things that come after me, right? I just want to say congratulations to all of you that were here. I hopefully that you enjoyed your day today, and hopefully you'll enjoy your day tomorrow. And I just want to say thank you for experimenting, exploring, discovering, and dreaming about how to make the world better each and every day. So thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Henderson. We were honored this afternoon to have some of the best professionals in the STEM world with us. You learned about different STEM careers, what is important to keep you going, and hopefully that has sparked in you a continuation or a hope to continue your exploration in the STEM world. Next, we're excited to introduce Dr. Tyler Johnson. Dr. Johnson is a microbiologist at the FDA in Washington, D.C. He is also a 2002 to 2004 alum of our very own SSTFI competition. So let's welcome Dr. Tyler Johnson to the stage, to the podium.
What's up, fellow science nerds?
Slides up.
Okay. So my name's Tyler Johnson. I am a microbiologist at the FDA Center for Veterinary Medicine. I am a proud Iowa State Science Fair alumnus back 24 years ago. There we go. Okay. So next slide, please. All right, so because I work for the government, they make me say this fancy disclaimer language that makes me sound way more important than what I really am. So here it is. The one thing I will say about my job, sometimes government scientists get a bad rap, is I love my job. I was in the United States Army before I came to the FDA, and I get the same sense of fulfillment, public service, you know, working with public health to keep animals and humans safe and healthy in this country. And I know all my colleagues do too, so it's a great, I'm very proud of the work we do at the FDA. So, next slide, please. All right, that deadbeat is me 24 years ago. I was a freshman in high school, and that's a sixth place medal wrapped around my neck. And if you're wondering, why does it look like he hasn't slept for 2 days? Because I hadn't slept for 2 days. Instead of preparing myself for science fair and communication skills and all these really important skills I should have been learning, I was running around the hotel causing chaos. And I can look around the audience and see some of those in here. My legacy lives on. So next slide, please. So here are some transcripts, and I'll circle back why I'm including these, not just to be self-deprecating. But that one, so what's that, stage right, where you see a 2.52? That's my cumulative GPA. It took me 5 years to get a bachelor's in science. The first 3 years were at Central College in Pella. Last 2 years were at the University of Iowa. That's right, I'm a Hawkeye. And that 2.52 means I averaged somewhere between a B and a C during all my classes in 5 years. And that other one, what's that stage left where you see that GPA 1.89? That is the low point of my academic career. That 1.89 means I was put on academic probation because I averaged less than a C. If you're wondering what a day in the life was like for me that semester, as I'd wake up, flunk a biochem test, and then hustle to the other side of campus and crush people in racquetball. And I remember finding out halfway through the semester they don't give A's in racquetball. And so I just quit showing up to racquetball. And the reason I show you this, you know, obviously I wish all of you straight A's, and you do your whatever career you want. I hope you do it the first time you try. But I want you to know who thinks they have to get straight A's to be successful? Who puts a ton of pressure on themselves to get straight A's? Be honest. I know you're all tryhards, you're here. Okay. Hey, I'll tell you a secret. You don't have to get straight A's to be successful. I didn't really have any sense of direction or purpose until I was in my mid-20s. Again, I don't recommend that, but if you fail something and you love it and you want to keep doing it, try again. Fail over and over and over and over if you have to. Nobody has failed more than me. I promise you that. Fail spectacularly. And to circle back to that picture, that's me as a high school freshman in 2000. I didn't go back my sophomore year. I didn't go back my junior year. I was pretty much against my will forced to go my senior year, didn't try very hard and had nothing to show for it, obviously. I always knew I wanted to do science, so I kept working at it, and my career took a few sideways paths, but I'm exactly where I want to be. So as you're going through your young career, don't be afraid to fail. And if you get a C, but you're trying hard, who cares? Like, it really who cares? All right? That C isn't going to define you. All right? Next slide, please. All right. So my two very, very simple keys to being successful: work hard and don't be a jerk. That's it. Seems simple. Be amazed how many people don't have both of these figured out, either or. So within that, it is the most important part of Science Fair that you all are doing, you might not even realize it, is learning how to communicate. It's uncomfortable explaining your science project to somebody, especially if you see an old guy like me come up and you're trying to explain what you did. But you know what, even if you're a sixth grader and it's your first ever science experiment, you're the expert in that, I am not. And so learning to be comfortable explaining that is essential to being a scientist. And so the more of these science fairs you get into, and the more times you throw yourself out there and like push through that comfort, it'll be nothing but good things for you. One thing I think my generation of scientists and older have done a really poor job of is maintaining the ability to communicate their science and medicine to the general public. I think sometimes it can come off as condescending, and sometimes it seems like you're just speaking over people's heads. Unnecessarily so. Scientists sometimes use big words when they don't need to use big words. You can say use instead of utilize. It's not the end of the world. So my challenge for all of you, if you really want to get into science and medicine, is as you're progressing and getting more specialized, maintain the ability to communicate your science to the general public. All right? A mechanic couldn't come tell me what's wrong with my engine in detail. I wouldn't have a clue what he's talking about. And so I don't think we should expect a scientist to be able to speak in a way that the general public has never had a training in, okay? So always check in on yourself as you're going through college to make sure, like, hey, if I'm explaining this to a fifth grader, would they make sense of it? And then my hope is by the time you're my age, the general public is starting to get their medical advice from scientists and, you know, medical doctors instead of like this. Right now, it seems like a lot of that advice is from the cesspools of YouTube, like bro science doc, instead of like an actual research doctor, right? So really work on that communication piece. And the last part, this kind of ties into communicating, is network. The world revolves around networking. Meet people, get to know people, reach out to them. If you see a science project, a lot of you did brilliant lit reviews. If you see something that's really, really interesting, reach out to that scientist. Their email's there. I tell you, nothing makes a scientist feel better. A lot of those, it looks like a 3 or 4 page article. That might be 5 years of somebody's life. So if a seventh grader, a ninth grader, 11th grader reaches out and says, hey, Dr. So-and-so, like, why'd you do this? For me, I stop what I'm doing. I answer because I'm like, oh, that's awesome. Somebody actually read this. So, and then you never know when you're looking at grad schools. I mean, how I was invited to come up here, I had never met Alexa, but through a friend of a friend, we got to know each other, and I ended up in Ames. So always make sure you're building those relationships. You never know how they'll pay off. All right, last slide. So this, I like being self-deprecating. This kind of makes me sound non-humble, but I wake up every day trying to do something to make myself and the world around me better. I don't succeed at that every day, but that's how I wake up, with that intent. And I've got a couple other quotes up here that help center me when I'm not feeling very motivated, but it's amazing just with like the simple things, how you can find purpose in your life. That picture of me in the middle, that's me teaching ninth graders in Nepal. These students would walk miles every day for 6 days a week to go get an education. None of them had plumbing. Most of them didn't have electricity. And I went in there naive American thinking like, I'm gonna teach them like basic scientific method stuff. And then one of the principals pulled me aside and he's like, hey, they're learning the chemical reactions of photosynthesis. Like, you can up your game a little bit. And so it reminds me that no matter where you're at, science is global. And it's an awesome career. It'll take you all over the world. I've got to travel all over the world for my job. And we need scientists in this country. And I really energized and excited seeing some of the projects you all have as junior high and high schoolers, the stuff I was doing in grad school, and I'm not that old. So keep up the good work. I'm proud of you, and great job. I want to shout out to teachers. You all are grossly underpaid, grossly overworked, and you have the most important job in this country. You're the foundation which all other careers are built off of. I know it can be hard sometimes, but it's worth it. I have my high school science teacher and my junior high science teacher from Central East still here. They're both retired, but they're up here. And it's a calling, and it's incredible what you all do, and I appreciate every one of you. One more shout out, because he drove all the way up here, is for my dad. So I don't know if he knows this yet, but my middle initial is J for Joseph. That's my dad's name. And I started using that middle initial in my professional paperwork once I got my PhD because, you know, obviously my mom and dad I owe everything to, but my dad specifically instilled my work ethic in me. And so I use that J in my professional paperwork as a way to honor him because although it was against my will, he taught me how to work hard. And that reminds me when I sign off those papers, just thanks to Dad. So love you, Dad. And lastly, and then I swear I'll get out of here, Alexa. Awesome. This place, you honor your grandpa's legacy amazingly. And I know he's smiling down like, it's so cool being back here. So thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Johnston. The State Science and Technology Fair of Iowa operates every year through the generous support of general sponsors from across the state. These sponsors are committed to supporting quality science education throughout the science fair. Most importantly, they truly believe in the students of Iowa, and they hope that science will be a career path that many researchers just like you all will might someday choose to follow. This year, nearly $50,000 was raised in support of the fair. Scholarships for the 2024 fair will total over $100,000. Other money raised goes to support the prizes, medallions, and costs to run the fair and the International Science and Engineering Fair trip to Los Angeles. In short, none of this would be possible without our sponsors. So let's make sure all our sponsors know they are greatly appreciated. Any sponsors who are joining us this evening, would you please stand for a moment to be recognized? There we go. All right. All day you've seen people walking throughout Hilton here with red lanyards and green ribbons on their name badges. Can anyone tell me who that group of people was? Nice. Okay, I didn't need to say it twice. Judges, yes, if you didn't hear. Let's give all of our dedicated volunteers and our judges here a big round of applause. Now, I believe we're going to get into some awards. So in order to do that, we got to get you oriented as to where you're supposed to go, how you're supposed to come up on stage, and all that stuff here, too. So listen with me for a minute. I got to make sure I read this right as well. So if your name is called, you may only enter the stage from my left over here on this side. There, you're going to enter the stage and make your way as fast as you can to the stage without falling or tripping or anything like that. I almost did that earlier. Do not run. If you cross the stage, you will exit the stage over here to my right and then head over to the picture area you're going to see over there when you come down here, tucked away over on that side. If your award is awarded to multiple people, then the photo will be a group photo over there. They'll take care of that. Following the photo, you will be given further award information and distribution and all sorts of that information as needed. All students, regardless of whether you receive additional information behind the stage or not, are required to follow this path to keep the award ceremony running as smoothly as possible. Now, we are going to start by awarding the Iowa FFA AgriScience Fair Awards, followed by special awards and sponsored scholarships. Now, we would like to welcome to the stage Alan Spencer, who's the FFA AgriScience Fair Coordinator. Also, I'm sorry, yeah? I was going to welcome you back up to the stage. It's your part next. All right, please welcome back to the stage the director of the fair, Alexa Groff.
I know you have to read some parts. Speaking, okay, okay. All right, I'll make this quick. Tonight we're partnering, oh wait, no, it is not me because we're missing a part of the script. We do want Alan Spencer to come to the stage, to the actual podium, to award the FFA AgriScience Awards. Sorry.
Yeah, it's all good.
It's good, we're improvising, it's
everything's
fine.
Everything's great.
It's great.
Hey, everything's awesome. Come on. Just like on the Lego movie. Okay, so welcome. My name's Alan Spencer. I'm the ag teacher at East Mills in Southwest Iowa. Today we will be presenting the Iowa FFA Association AgriScience Fair Awards. Those are given to, you can see lots of FFA members that we have here in the audience today that have been here. We have, 19,765 FFA members or so in the state of Iowa in about 250 high schools. It's the largest career and technical student organization in the state. And we're very proud to be able to have that here along with our State Science and Technology Fair of Iowa. So with us today are Will Vlasek. He is the Southeast State Vice President and for the Iowa FFA Association, and Emma Humphreys, who is the Iowa FFA reporter. And they will be having state FFA convention here in this building for 5,000 people here in about a week and a half or less. So we're gonna start. We have our FFA, categories are put together. We have several different categories. We have animal systems, environmental services, natural resources, food products and processing, plant systems, and power structural and technical, and social systems. And within those categories, everybody's divided up by ages, and so in those, Division One, for instance, is 7th through 8th grade individual, Division Two is 7th through 8th grade team, Division Three is 9th through 10th individual, Division Four is 9th through 10th team, Division 5 is 11th through 12th grade individual, and Division 6 is 11th through 12th grade team. So we're going to work through these as categories. We're going to have animal systems come up first. They will receive a medallion, and then I will explain the process for the other awards that will go on as we go through the system. Okay? Ready? Okay, let's go. So we're going to start with animal systems. In Division 1, we had the first place is Lizeth Cordes from Beckman Catholic. She could come on down. In Division 3, animal systems, starting in third place is Molly Snyder from Beckman. Second place is Valerie Rye from Beckman Catholic. And in first place, Division Three, is Allison Gruntmeyer from Central Lee. Division Four, which is our 9th and 10th grade teams, is from MMCRU, Brennan Ball, and Lauren Gales. They could come on down. They're in the cheap seats. Okay, come on down. And then in Division 5, the last category that we have in animal systems is Ellie Hartman from Beckman Catholic, first place. Let them get up on stage quickly. So what they all are receiving are first, second, third place medallions that they will have. And then, once we get everybody over there, we will name the overall top placing in animal systems who will receive a certificate that's in the packet your teacher will pick up afterward is Allison Gruntmeyer from Central Lee. Top overall.
It's okay, you'll get a certificate later.
We're all good. We're all good. We're just giving them a round of applause, please. Okay, Environmental Services Natural Resources Systems. Our middle school, 7th and 8th grade, Division 1. In third place is Jacob Baker from Holy Trinity. Second place, Zane Houts from Holy Trinity. And Chase Menke in first place from Holy Trinity. In Division 3, which is individuals, Natalie Bressler from Beckman Catholic is third. Second place is Rory Piscatelli from Marshalltown. All right, and in first place, Division 3, Environmental Natural Resources, is J.C. Campbell from Mount Pleasant. That's Mount Pleasant, so that's first place. Okay, in Division 4, third place, Kelsey Hilsenbeck and Haley Shack from North Scott. There they come. Okay, just making sure to keep them in order. Second place is Ava Oberbrockling and Chloe Thier from Beckman Catholic. And in first place, Reese Conrad and Gavin Searin from Kyoto. In Division 5, which is individuals in 10th and 11th grade, or 11th and 12th grade, Mia Schlomer from Linmar in third place. Second place is Andrew Salrin from Beckman Catholic. And first place is Sydney Gruntmeyer from Central Lee. And also, while she's walking across, the top project in Environmental Services Natural Resources was Sydney Gruntmeyer from Central Lee. Let's give all of them a round of applause. Go ahead. Okay, food products and processing. First place in Division 1, Katie Helly from Beckman Catholic. In Division 3, third place, Taylor Crane from North Scott. In second place, Ellie Hellman from Holy Trinity. And in first place, Alexander Kerper from Beckman Catholic. In Division 4 teams, Ashley Schilling and Annabelle Zaradnik for second place from Beckman. And in first place, Division 4, Marilena Cockshoot and Kale Mess from North Scott. In Division 5, second place, Mary McKean from Beckman Catholic. And in first place, Everett Fetters from Sioux Center. Division 6, which is the team category for 11th and 12th grade. Second place to Madison Behema and Isabel Van S. from Sioux Center. And in first place, Addison Harms and Sydney Groan from North Scott. And the overall top project in food products and processing is Marilena Cockshoot and Kale Mess from North Scott. Okay, let's give them all another round of applause.
Go ahead.
In plant systems, which was our largest category, Division One, third place, Kelly Mueller from Holy Trinity. In second place, Bryn Hageman from Beckman. And in first place, Nora Deep from North Scott. Division II teams. Second place, Jenna Spurfsloggy and Vivian Ray from Beckman. And in first place, Trenton Smith and Lane Simon from Cascade. Division III, third place, Isaac Geistemper from Beckman. Second place, Cassidy Bierstead from Algona. And in first place, Wyatt Eekhoff from West Hancock. Okay, is Wyatt here? Wes Hancock? Okay, we'll set that one aside. Okay, second place in Division Four, Claire Gall and Autumn Domeyer from Beckman. And Division Four, first place, Owen Bogie and Sophia Dunkel from Beckman. Plant Systems, Division 5. Third place from Stanton, Clark Spencer. Second place, Marie Grebner from Beckman. And in first place, Division 5, Hannah Wildstra from Sioux Center. And in Division 6, first place, Ashley Mose and Brianna Shimkus from North Scott. And the overall top plant systems project is Hannah Wildstra from Sioux Center. Let's give our plant systems projects another round of applause. Next is Power Structural and Technical Systems. Division One, third place, Nick Menke from Holy Trinity. Second place, Oscar Herbers from Beckman. And first place, Emma Menke from Holy Trinity. Division Two, first place, Devin Schlicky and Colin Rieker from Beckman. Division Three, third place, Sayamala Akula from Linmar. Second place, Division Three, Jackson Haverkamp from North Scott. And in first place, Division Three, is Kenneth Helley from Beckman.
So she's third, he's second. You got that? Andrea, was that the second place? No.
You need to go trade with him. Switch those around.
Okay, in Division Four. Second place, Andrew Rowling and Stephen Rowling from Beckman. And in first place, Allison Nipper and Andrea Schneider from Beckman. In Division 5, first place, Libby Hageman from Beckman. And Division Six, first place from East Mills, Wyatt Schmidt and Ailey Marburger. And the overall top power structural and technical systems project is Emma Menke from Holy Trinity. Let's give our power structural and technical members a round of applause as they leave the stage. Final category for this evening is social systems. First place, Division One, Sebastian Jones from North Scott. Division Two, first place, Bryn Burlidge and Brock Burlidge from Beckman. Division Three, first place, Brianna Perk from Beckman. Division Five, first place, Charissa Heisler from Beckman. Division Six, second place, Anna Cordes and Madeline Ryder from Beckman. And Division Six, first place, Jordan Jones and Cole Wessel from North Scott. And the overall top project in social systems was Jordan Jones and Cole Wessel from North Scott. Let's give them all a round as we go off the stage. Go ahead. So, just so teachers know, The ag teachers of all the students that receive first place in each of their categories will be receiving an email from the Iowa FFA Association. They have an opportunity to be able to submit paperwork to be sent to the National FFA later this in the next couple months, and then those students will be considered to be accepted to the National FFA Convention in October in Indianapolis. And so they'll have a chance to submit that paperwork. One other thing that we do tonight is we recognize division winners. So the division winners of Division One, the different categories, they will be recognized on stage today, but they will receive plaques on stage at the state FFA convention in this room on May 15th. So, Division One, if they could come down, Division One, which is seventh and eighth grade individual, the top division winner was Nora Deep from North Scott. Division Two, seventh and eighth grade teams, Trenton Smith and Lane Simeon from Cascade. Division III, 7th and 10th grade individuals. From Beckman Catholic, Alexander Kerper. Division IV, 9th and 10th grade teams that will be recognized at state convention, Reese Conrad and Gavin Serum from Keota. Division 5, 11th and 12th grade individuals, Sydney Gruntmeyer from Central Lee. And finally, Division 6, that will be recognized at the state FFA convention, Wyatt Schmidt and Ailey Marburger from East Mills. We appreciate you helping with all the applause and everything today as we've been going through our FFA awards. It's quite extensive, and hopefully that's helped out with the timing that you need for the rest of the script. So that's a good thing. So that's awesome. So we will be, once Wyatt and Ailey get up here, let's give all of our FFA participants another round of applause. And thank you very much for your time, and we would like to welcome Zane back to the podium, right? Zane is the right one? Or we'll have Alexa come back to the podium. Thank you very much.
Thanks. Sorry. All right. Tonight, we are partnering with four different universities and colleges from across the state and three organizations who will be offering scholarships this year. This could not be possible without the wonderful people who will be up here shortly, and I want to take a second to thank each scholarship partner and their dedication to STEM research and the youth in Iowa. So let's give a round of applause for those scholarship donors. This is a testament to all of your hard work and dedication to STEM research. All right, let's get this moving. Please help me welcome to the stage a representative from Iowa Bio.
Good evening. I'm Jessica Hyland, the Executive Director of the Iowa Biotechnology Association, and we are here today to present are five $2,000 Future Biotech Leader Scholarships. And with me are some of the members of our association that work for some of the coolest companies in the state, and they're going to introduce themselves and then present the awards. Thank you.
Hi, I'm Nathan Brewer, and I'm part of Kent Corporation, headquartered in Muscatine, Iowa, and we're a proud supporter of the Iowa Biotech Association and the STEM efforts in the state. So thank you again for all of your work put into these fabulous projects.
Hey, everyone. Luke Bibby. I'm from ProLiant Health and Biologicals, just down the road in Ankeny. Family-owned company from right here in Iowa. Really been impressed here today. I was one of the judges, so really amazing stuff here, and really excited to give these scholarships out.
Evening, everyone. Todd Anderson. I'm part of CJ Bio America. We are up in Fort Dodge, Iowa, but we are part of the CJ Xiaojiedang Corporation out of Seoul, South Korea, is where our headquarters are. So we make advanced feed-grade essential amino acids. And really, on behalf of the company as well as Iowa Bio, thank you for all of you attending. Thank you for all of you participating.
All right. These are in no special order. First is Sabrina Du. She's on her way. Kelly Takur Basong. I didn't get around to all of the scholarship recipients there. I did see Kelly's. It was pretty impressive stuff. So. Priscilla Kangney. Aiden Koenig. And last but not least, Judith Williams. And thanks again. I don't know, Jessica, if you want to say anything more, but thanks again on behalf of Iowa Bio again. I'm really, really excited to be here. Thanks, everyone.
All right, thank you to Iowa Bio. That's a fantastic opportunity for our juniors and seniors to, once you're registered for the fair, an email will go out to any junior or senior that is registered to apply for that scholarship. So please look out for that if you're a sophomore or a junior for next year. And take full advantage of that. So please help me welcome to the stage Maddie Sammy from Iowa State University College of Ag and Life Sciences.
Good evening, everyone. My name's Madison Howell.
And I'm Sammy Notaboom.
We're ambassadors for the College of Agriculture and Life Sciences here at Iowa State. We would like to congratulate each and every one of you for making it this far. Tonight, we will be presenting six scholarships from the Ag and Life Sciences categories. These projects were judged based on exemplary communication and project relevance. For a $500 scholarship upon enrolling in Iowa State University College of Agriculture and Life Sciences, Sammy will now be reading the names of the recipients.
Our first one is Aiden Coing. Next up is Callie Lennertz. Kira Campbell. JC Campbell. Everett Fetters. And lastly, Hannah Woodstra. I'd like to congratulate all the recipients.
Thank you to Iowa State University College of Ag and Life Sciences. Please help me welcome to the stage representatives from Iowa State University College of Engineering.
Okay, good evening, everyone. My name is Jamil Perez. I serve currently as Assistant Director for Engineering Outreach and Talent Development. This is our third year sponsoring scholarships through SSTFI, and we've seen some of these students join Iowa State College of Engineering programs over the last few years. And we have scholarship winners from last year that were juniors and may be joining us in the fall, so we're excited to have some of those students join us as well. Along with that, this year we evaluated 30-some projects that we felt fit into the programs that we were looking to evaluate, and there were four categories that our team evaluated projects on. Those categories are engineering goals, creative ability, independent work and skill, as well as thoroughness and clarity. These are areas that engineers need to be skilled at as they go through programs at Iowa State, and so today, I don't think I ever told you how many we were doing. I changed my mind. It's more than what we were gonna do. So we're recognizing, I think it came out to, I'm gonna do 8 projects. One of them is a 2 people in the same project. So we're recognizing 9 students, and all 9 students will receive a $1,000 scholarship when they join Iowa State University College of Engineering. So there are 15 majors within the college. In any of those majors, they would get $1,000 during their first year on campus. In no order in particular, when I call your name, if you would like to come up, and Alexa will hand you a bag. I also have certificates that I can give you once we step off the stage. In the category of chemistry, Kelly Takorbisung, and I apologize if I mispronounce anybody's name. Also in chemistry, Jessica Maravilla Solano. In earth and environmental science, Priscilla Cangini. Our duo team in robotics and intelligent machines, Bergen Klein and William Faber. In the engineering category, Keshav Sinolia. In energy and transportation, Anjali Lod. We have three in energy and transportation. So also in energy and transportation, Joyce Wang. And then last but not least, in energy and transportation, Emerson Waltz. And congratulations, there were some amazing, this was not an easy decision, there were some amazing projects out there. And so we wanted to recognize everyone. So thank you for everything that you do, and we look forward to seeing you as you go along. Thank you.
Jamil always surprises me. She used to be my coworker, and now she's not, which is kind of sad. But I love when she surprises me with more scholarships than she originally told me she was going to give. So thank you to the College of Engineering, and congratulations to those who just received scholarships. Can you please help me welcome to the stage representatives from Iowa State University Department of Industrial Manufacturing Systems Engineering?
All right, hello, I'm Michelle Stallard, and I'm a professor here at Iowa State University teaching Industrial Manufacturing Systems Engineering. ISU's Industrial and Manufacturing Systems Engineering Department's roots began in 1929, 95 years ago. From its humble beginnings to now, in 2024, IMSE, as it's known, is proud to own the concept of continuous improvement in the courses it teaches, in the research it does, and its engagement with society. This year, we are awarding four Believe, Achieve, IE Outstanding Industrial Engineering Scholarships in the amount of $500 each to two high school students and two middle school students whose projects best represent the ideas of improving processes to help people doing it better, faster, cheaper, and safer. The topics of the selected projects this evening include topics in data analytics, human-computer interaction, machine learning, and ergonomics. Many of your projects actually fit into some of these IE categories, so you may be surprised when you hear some of the names that we've called. Industrial engineers work with all of these industries and more, and we want to recognize all those projects here tonight who fit into the IE category. All right, so let's begin here announcing some of the winners here. So we do have four winners, and on behalf of IMSE and the Industrial Engineering Department, I would like to ask the winners to receive their certificate and then stand up front by me so that way we can all see you and recognize you for all of your hard work. First up, we've got Adam Zhu from Ames High School, whose project is Effectiveness of Automated Communication Strategies in School Shooting Evacuations. Up next, we've got Benjamin Lavimer from Mid Prairie Homeschool Assistance Program with open source myoelectric robotics prosthetics and additive manufacturing. We also have to recognize Winston Fan from West Senior High School, whose project is detecting and quantifying emotional loneliness risk in the digital age. And then finally, we want to recognize Pajita Makanda from Mashariji High School, whose project was around accessible color detection. When these students enroll at Iowa State University in the Industrial Engineering Department, these scholarships will be automatically applied to their tuition with the hopes of encouraging them to pursue their dreams of problem solving at the highest levels. We would like to congratulate all these students and look forward to seeing more of you and enter some industrial engineering projects next year. Thank you.
All right, thank you to the College of IMSE. Please help me welcome to the stage Landon Calderwood from Iowa State University College of Human Sciences.
Good evening, everyone. My name is Landon Calderwood. I'm the Campus Visits Coordinator for the College of Human Sciences here at Iowa State University. In our college, we focus on topics from everything from fashion to fitness, families to financial counseling, foods to our future educators. And so we cover a very large range of topics. that are definitely very prevalent here at the State Science and Technology Fair. So in total, myself and some of our student ambassadors were able to judge 48 different projects today that we saw had a direct connection to some topics in our college. And I'm excited to award six of those individuals a $1,000 scholarship that they can use towards their first year of education at Iowa State in a major in the College of Human Sciences. And so when I read your name, please come up. Our first award winner is Christine Condren from Keokuk Schools for her project titled The Investigation of Which Color Muslim Best Aids in the Curing of Jaundice. Alexander Kerper from Beckman Catholic High School for his mechanical properties of kernza and grain flours in relations to food preparation. Ellie Hellman from Holy Trinity Schools for her project of peak performance. Pujita Makadam from Maharishi School for her project titled Accessible Color Detection. And then a group of two students, Jaden Schwartz and Preston Johnson from Marshalltown High School for their project titled Breaking Boundaries, Exploring the Power of Carbon Fiber in Running Shoes. So we had a very hard time reviewing all of the different projects today and had about 20 that we had to sift through in the end to come up with our final award winners. So great work, and we are excited to hopefully see most of you next year.
Thanks to Landon and the College of Human Sciences. I don't know if you noticed, but I thoroughly enjoy getting handed things up here and then peeking at the winners before you guys know. So, yes. Please help me welcome to the stage representatives from Loras College. Guys, I know something you don't know, if you know. Do you want the mic?
Yeah.
Okay.
She almost gave away all my secrets. Hi, everyone. My name is Maria Gentile, and I'm the Director of Undergraduate Admission at Loras College in Dubuque, Iowa.
Hello, everyone. I am Associate Professor Dr. Adam Mosier, and I teach chemistry at Loras College.
This event is like Christmas for Dr. Mosier, so it is the best. He's pretty happy. So, honored has turned out to be a little bit of an understatement for Loras' presence at this event. All of your projects were absolutely amazing. Loras College strives to provide an education where students develop into reflective thinkers, active learners, responsible contributors, and ethical decision makers. This is especially true for the students in STEM and health sciences at our college, where research directly with PhD faculty begins the moment you step foot on campus. We are a small school in a vibrant community doing big things. Our ABET-accredited engineering program was named top five nationally, and we participate in the Iowa Space Grant Consortium through NASA. Recently, five students received the National Honor Society in Neuroscience Research Award to support their projects. And last year, a record 98.6% of Loras graduates were working in their desired field or were admitted to grad and professional programs within 6 months of graduation. With that, we are pleased to support future DUHOCs by providing over 50 scholarships this evening. For these awards, you will actually remain seated, but you can pick up your scholarship certificates tomorrow morning at the Loras College booth. All right, let's get going. So, these scholarships will range, depending on your grade in school, between $500 and $1,000. The awards this year go to Ellie Hartman, Addison Peterson, Allison Gruntmeyer, Sahana Najarin, Madeline Grothis, Gabriana Ramirez, Aiden Koenig, Marla Anya Cockshoot, Kale Mess, Christine Condren, Soraya Sanchez, Addison Harms, Sydney Gronit, Cole Wessel, Jordan Jones, Josue Corral Coronado, Izzy Gray. Alexander Kerper, Adam Salem, Kelly Korpisog, Ellie Hellman, Mila Hoffman, Kenneth Helly, Ninti Tar, Josue Hernandez Rea, Johanna Marquin, Jessica Marvel Solana, Kiera Campbell. Lots of pages. Alice Knipper. Andrea Schneider. Keshav Sinaloa. Aiden Dostalik. Savannah Vitt. Benjamin Lothamer. Chisara Hessler, Lillian Rosario, Reese Conrad, Gavin Serene, JC Campbell, Timothy Lee, Vienna Rosmanith, Mila Grothis, Valerie Rahe, Macy Doty, Ashton Putman, Kirsten McNally, Antikarisha Sharma, Everett Fetters, Riley Schinger, Abby Lempe, Mahi Patel, Sharia Ravada, Savani Ram, Marie Grebner, Taylor Almond, Clark Spencer, Briar Bender. And I sort of lied a little bit. We are going to have one presenter today come up to the stage. I think for the first time this is happening. Ish?
Yeah, I've been around for a long time.
Okay. Okay. We are going to be offering a full tuition scholarship to one presenter today, to Loras College. And that recipient can come to the stage, and it is Sabrina Dew.
All right, I don't know if you guys understand what just happened, but she's going to Loras for free.
Also, I know how much Adam loves this science fair. Last year was his first time, and then we talked over the summer, and he's like, this is my Christmas, I love it so much. And I'm like, you understand how I feel about this event. I like it. And in talks with them, multiple talks since last summer, they're like, we have something up our sleeve. And I said, oh my gosh, tell me it's a full ride scholarship. And they're like, how did you know? I'm like, I don't know, it was a guess. But so I told you I knew something you didn't know. So those of you who got scholarships from Loras, let's give them all a round of applause again. I know that we were trying to save some time because obviously you can see here behind me, we've still got a ways to go. And Zane kills it in the special awards department on getting us through. So we need you guys to go as fast as you can up here without falling, without running, and around. So I would like to thank all the colleges and universities here tonight. We appreciate their support of our fair, the research that all of you guys do, and their continued support. So congratulations to tonight's scholarship recipients. Let's welcome back to the podium our MC for tonight's special award ceremony, Zane Satry.
All right, people, buckle in. We got this many awards to get through here. So tonight, the State Science and Technology Fair of Iowa is pleased to present special awards that are sent to the fair as an affiliate of the Regeneron International Science and Engineering Fair. These sponsors present awards at all Intel ISEF affiliated state and regional fairs across the country. Before we get started, I will preemptively apologize in advance for anyone's name that I butcher. I feel your pain. No one has ever said my last name right the first time either, so sorry. All right, let's start with the American Psychological Association Award. We've got four winners here. First, Cole Wessel and Jordan Jones from North Scott. Mallory Ree from Beckman Catholic. Kaylee Muller and Briley Cook from Central Lee Middle School. Finley Judge, Miller Middle School. Next up, the winners of the award from the Association for Women Geoscientists. First, Lara Canita of Central Lee. Taylor Amon from West Central Valley. Rory Piscatelli from Marshalltown. Addison Hull from Central Lee Middle School. Rachel Buke from Central Lee Middle School. And Macy Anderson from Central Lee Middle School. Those are the winners of the award from the Association for Women Geoscientists. Next up is the NASA Earth System Science Award. Six winners here. First up, Taylor Amon from West Central Valley. Taylor, you'll just have to kind of come back. Cassidy Bierstedt from Algona. Shanza Sammy from Iowa City West. Aubrey Bunnell and Hadley Rohde from Central Lee Middle School. Arabella McDowell from Central Lee Middle School. And Kaylee Stark from Central Lee Middle School. Those are our winners from the NASA Earth System Science Award. And now the National Oceanic and Atmospheric Administration Award. The NOAA Award will go to one individual whose research emphasizes NOAA's mission of science, service, and stewardship. The three winners of the NOAA Award are as follows: Logan Foltz, Sioux Center; Kira Campbell from Keokuk; and Joyce Wang from Maharishi. Just kidding, there's three more. I had to turn the page. Next three, Jonathan C. from Central Lee Middle School. James Marquis from Miller Middle School. And now finally, Oscar Herbers from Beckman Catholic. Now on to the award from the Office of Naval Research. The Office of Naval Research is committed to supporting science, technology, engineering, and mathematics initiatives and programs for our nation's young students. Middle school winners will receive a certificate of achievement and a medallion. High school winners will receive a certificate of achievement and medallions as well. The winners of the award from the Office of Naval Research are Arabella McDowell from Central Lee Middle School. Uliana Marcuzia from Ames Middle School. Addison Hole from Central Lee. Addison Kaneda from Central Lee. Ruby Jacob from Valley. And Aurora Edens from Central Lee. Now on to the Regeneron Biomedical Science Award. This award provides one $375 award and a certificate to an exceptional student scientist or team of scientists who not only demonstrate an impressive command of biomedical science and research, but also embody Regeneron's core values and behaviors known as the Regeneron Way. The winner of the Regeneron Biomedical Science Award is Christine Condren of Keokuk. While Christine comes up here, we'll now move on to the RICO Awards. The next award comes from RICO USA. It's awarded to projects that address social and environmental challenges for a more sustainable future. The winners of the RICO Award are as follows. Shanza Sammy from Iowa City West. Priscilla Congeny from Iowa City West. Reese Conrad and Gavin Siren from Kyoto. Sebastian Jones from North Scott. Addison Hull from Central Lee. And Jenna Spurslagi and Vivian Ray from Beckman Catholic. Now on to the award from the Society for In Vitro Biology. Two winners here. First up, Sophia Dunkel and Owen Boge from Beckman Catholic. And Olivia Cook from Central Lee. Now the winners of the awards from the U.S. Agency for International Development, otherwise known as USAID. Five winners here. First up, Emerson Waltz from Algona. Haley Smith from Central Lee. Clark Spencer from Stanton. Liliana Kalisar from Bethel Heights Academy. And finally, Zeta Kruger and Brielle Sauer from Sheldon Middle School. Now on to the awards from the U.S. Metric Association. First up, Mila Grothas from Madrid. Natalie Alberts from Keokuk. Ayla Zinner from Keokuk. Grayson Grafton from Central Lee. Emily Unkin from Timothy Christian. And Charlie Wessels from Timothy Christian. Those are the award winners from the U.S. Metric Association. Now on to the U.S. Stockholm Junior Water Prize. The Stockholm Junior Water Prize is the most prestigious international award for a water-related science project at the high school level. After awarded here today, the research papers from each state will be compiled and sent to that state's association, where a panel of water quality experts will judge and select that state's winning project, and then the overall state winner receives an all-expenses-paid trip to the national competition. This two-day event offers educational and entertaining events and is where the U.S. winner is announced. The national competition is this coming June 15th through 18th at the Colorado School of Mines in Golden, Colorado. So the winner of tonight's U.S. Stockholm Junior Water Prize is Addison Hole from Central Lee Middle School. Now on to the U.S. Air Force Awards. Four winners here. First up, Benjamin Lothamer from Mid Prairie Homeschool. Kelly Tuckerbysong from Keokuk. Sarah Rowling from Beckman Catholic. And Sydney Gruntmeyer from Central Lee. Now the winners of the award from the Yale Science and Engineering Association. First up, Angelie Lode from Iowa City West. Joyce Wang from Maharishi. And June's son from Iowa City West. Now we will move on to some other special awards. This evening, we're pleased to present special awards that are sponsored by numerous Iowa clubs, companies, organizations, individuals, families, and colleges. These awards speak to the belief that these sponsors have in the value of student science research and science education. First up, the Discovery in Science Award. It's awarded to honor youth in their discovery of science through STEM research here at the fair. This year's four winners are James Marquis of Miller Middle School, Priscilla Conjney of Iowa City West, Oscar Herbers of Beckman Catholic, and Rory Piscatelli of Marshalltown. Now on to the Excellence in Food Science Awards. First winner, Gianna Stevens, MMCRU Middle School. Liliana Kolasar of Bethel Heights Academy. And Connor Brem of Urbandale. Now on to the Horizon Award. This award is for a student that demonstrates future potential for pursuing the field of science, someone who shows passion and excitement for research through a unique idea or research question. Our two winners of the Horizon Award this year are Macy Anderson of Central Lee Middle School and Liam Drollinger of Holy Trinity. Next up is the Excellence in Research Award. Three winners this year. First up, Aiden Koenig of Danville. Lauren Van Houn of Ames Middle School. And Evelyn Atkins of Central Lee Middle School. Now on to the Inform Award. One winner this year, who is Morgan Christensen of Madrid. Next up are the Excellence in Iowa 4-H Awards. The Excellence in 4-H Awards are demonstrated by the five program priority areas to youth who have demonstrated active learning and outstanding work in relation to that priority area of recognition. First category of STEM, the award, the Iowa 4-H Excellence in Science Award goes to Benjamin Lothamer of Mid Prairie Homeschool. In the area of healthy living, Sydney Gruntmeyer of Central Lee. The winner of Ag and Natural Resources, Audrey Snyder of Algona. In civic engagement and leadership, Brianna Perk of Beckman Catholic. And finally, communication and the arts to Mila Grothis of Madrid. Now on to the Iowa Junior Academy of Science Award, the Inspiration Award specifically. The Iowa Junior Academy of Science Inspiration Award for 2024 goes to Amal Etaib of Iowa City High. Next up is the Xeras Technology Award. And I believe we have a presenter for that. Is Mackenzie Clemens here to present that award?
Super awesome. Hi, I'm Mackenzie Clemens. I'm a director of research technology for Xeras, a technology consulting firm based out of West Des Moines, Iowa. I have the honor of awarding some Amazon gift certificates to two presenters today. The first is Benjamin Lothamer from Mid Prairie Homeschool Assistance Program. And then the second is Keegan Grundmeyer from South Hamilton. Congratulations.
Thank you, Mackenzie. Next up, we have Iowa State University's Excellence in Environmental Health and Safety Awards. The two winners of the award this year are Allison Gruntmeyer of Central Lee and Joyce Wang of Maharishi. Now on to the Allen Adams Inspiring Excellence Award. Stick with me, you got a few winners of this one. First up, Molly Snyder of Beckman Catholic. Valerie Ray of Beckman Catholic. Olivia Cook of Central Lee. Liliana Kalasar of Bethel Heights Academy. Jackson Haberkamp of North Scott. Logan Foltz of Sioux Center. Sydney Gruntmeyer of Central Lee. And Anthony Friedman of Beckman Catholic. Now, before we go, we also, well, we're not going to go anywhere. Before we go to the next award, we do have one more award specifically for inspiring excellence that goes not to a student, but to a teacher who has demonstrated dedication to their students' research. That Alan Adams Inspiring Excellence Teacher Award goes tonight to Tanya Jensen from Clarion Goldfield Dows. Now on to the Tinker Around Award. The winners of this year's SSTFI Tinker Around Awards are Uliana Marcuzia from Ames Middle School, Gabriel Thompson from Ames Middle School, and Madison Griffin from Holy Trinity Schools. Now on to the Computer Science Award. The winners of the SSTFI Iowa Computer Science Award for Outstanding Project in the area of computer science are Jackson Knopp of ACGC, Sunny Ma of Waukee Middle School, Caden Newton of Central Lee Middle School. And Pujita Mukadam of Maharishi. Next up is the Unity Point Health Patient Impact Award. The winner of this year's award is Ishita Mukadam of Maharishi. Now on to the Center for Non-Destructive Evaluation Awards. The Center for Non-Destructive Evaluation would like to award the following for their outstanding research. With a $100 gift card, Allison Nipper and Andrea Schneider of Beckman Catholic. With a $75 gift card, Dalton Kreibaum from Sioux Central, and with a $50 gift card, Anjali Lode from Iowa City West. Next up is Ray Gunn's Innovative Scientist Award. Ray Gunn has partnered with the State Science and Technology Fair of Iowa to award innovative ideas with, as you might guess, a custom t-shirt. The winners of this award are Adam Zhu of Ames High School and Kelly Tuckerby-Song of Keokuk. Now on to the Schneider Seed and Cattle Agricultural Excellence Awards. This year, Schneider Seed and Cattle Corporation would like to award four projects with their Agricultural Excellence Award. The four project winners this year are, first up, Everett Fetters from Sioux Center, Cole Wessel and Jordan Jones from North Scott, Cammy Helmke from Timothy Christian, and Sophia Roberts and Lauren Capps from Central Lee Middle School. On a similar note, now we'll award the Tri-County Ag Best Project Related to Ag Award. Four winners. First up, Hannah Woodstra from Sioux Center. Natalie Bessler from Beckman Catholic. Arabella McDowell from Central Lee Middle School. And Addison Hull from Central Lee Middle School. Next up is the Exceptional Biotechnology Project Award. The one winner of the Exceptional Biotechnology Project Award for 2024 is Kelly Tucker-Bisson from Keokuk. Now the Iowa 4-H Igniting STEM Exploration Award. The two winners of this award this year are Sarah Sanchez of Mount Pleasant and Kelsey Wilkinson from North Polk. Now the Iowa Wild Breakaway Scientist Award. This year's recipient is Drake Newton from Central Lee Middle School. Now on to the Excellence in Science Communication. The winners of these awards will get tickets to attend the Science Friday live event sponsored by the Office of the Vice President for Research here at Iowa State. And those winners are Addison Hull of Central Lee Middle School, Isabella Smith of Keokuk, Winston Fan of Iowa City West, Taylor Almond of West Central Valley, and Anna Cortez and Madeline Ryder of Beckman Catholic. Now on to the Thinking Outside the Box Excellence in Environmental Science Award. This award is presented by the Iowa DNR, who would like to award the following person for thinking outside the box when it comes to environmental science. Addison Hull of Central Lee Middle School. Next up is the Acura Healthcare Excellence in Healthcare Science. These awards, sponsored by Acura Healthcare, go to Adelie Daly of Central Lee Middle School, Derek Gruntmeyer of Central Lee Middle School, Bryn Hageman of Beckman Catholic, Nora Deep of North Scott, Evelyn Atkins of Central Lee Middle School, and Megan Perez of Algona. Those are the winners of the Acura Healthcare Excellence in Healthcare Science Award. Next up is the 4-H Member Excelling in Animal Science Award. Iowa 4-H would like to recognize two researchers who are excelling in the category specifically of animal science. Those two researchers are Allison Gruntmeyer of Central Lee and Ben Rosauer of Union High School. Now on to the SSTFI Excellence in Plant Science Award. The two winners of the Excellence in Plant Science Award this year are Hannah Woodstra of Sioux Center and Bryn Hageman of Beckman Catholic. We'll go now from excellence in plant science to agricultural innovation. The LandWorks Excellence in Agricultural Innovation Award, sponsored by LandWorks, has one winner this year, and it is Allison Gruntmeyer from Central Lee. Back to plant science. The Mayowa Ederju Plant Science Innovation Award goes to three people this year. First up, Briar Bender from Mount Pleasant. Taylor Almond from West Central Valley. And Nora Deep from North Scott. Now the Harvestville Farm Environmental Excellence Award. The winners of this year's Environmental Excellence Award, sponsored by Harvestville Farm, are Anjali Lowe of Iowa City West, Timothy Lee of Ames High School, Trenton Smith and Lane Simon of Cascade, and Chase Menke of Holy Trinity. Those are the winners of this year's Environmental Excellence Award, sponsored by Harvestville Farm. Now on to the Ag Leader Innovation Award. This year's Innovation Award, sponsored by Ag Leader, goes to two projects. First up, Allison Gruntmeyer of Central Lee. And Cassidy Bierstadt of Algona. Next up is the Innovation Award provided by the Space Force. One winner this year, Frankie Huther of North Pope. Now the Iowa DOT Innovation Award. This award by the Iowa DOT goes to, in the category of energy and transportation, Ava Horseman of West Hancock. Now on to the Home Run for Science Award, sponsored by the Iowa Cubs. The winner of this year's Home Run for Science Award is Titus Rosheim of Madrid. Now the Out of This World Award, sponsored by Blue Origin. One winner, Morgan Christensen of Madrid. Now on to the SSTFI Inspiring Inventor Award. This award this year goes to Jackson Knob of ACGC. The Invented for Life Award, sponsored by Bosch Motorsport. The Invented for Life Award for 2024 is presented to Allison Nipper and Andrea Schneider of Beckman Catholic. Now the High Tech for High Speed Award, also sponsored by Bosch Motorsport. The High Tech for High Speed Award goes to Joyce Wang of Maharishi. Now the Outstanding Environmental Project Award. Three winners. First up, Taylor Almond of West Central Valley. Hannah Woodstra of Sioux Center. Emerson Waltz of Algona. Well, the last couple winners are getting down here to the stage now. We would like to congratulate all of our special awards winners tonight. So let's do one more round of applause. I know you've had to applaud on that a lot lately. And as we do that, we would like to welcome Heather Gutknecht, the special awards chair, to the stage for our closing remarks.
All right, we actually have two more awards quick, and we are awarding out two awards to two teachers tonight because we wanna thank you for your commitment to science research in the classroom. The first award goes to Jim Goody from Sheldon Middle School. And I believe these awards are breakout boxes to be used in the classroom. I don't see Alexa, but. And the second award is to Aaron Dose from North Polk. As they're coming across the stage, I just want everyone to go ahead and give a big congratulations to all the students for their hard work and excellence in scientific research. We do have a few housekeeping items to go through. Anyone winning a scholarship prize, if you would like further information, we're gonna have you come over to the side of the stage to meet with our staff. Teachers, there is a list of thank yous, and teachers and students, actually, there is a list of thank yous that you can send out for our sponsors. Please be sure to write a letter of thanks to those people and organizations who have sponsored the fair. We will be back tomorrow, and judging is going to start promptly at 8:30 a.m. You all are asked to be at your projects by 8:15 a.m. We also have some thank yous that we need to do. To all our judges who donated their time and effort, to all our staff and volunteers. Thank you. And lastly, we would like to thank the man that managed to get through over 100 pages of names and awards to the special awards ceremony today, Zane Santari. Thank you so much. We hope you celebrate your achievements tonight, get a good night's rest, and we hope to see you all tomorrow. Thank you.